on the ground, lifeless. No one could guess that I had actually been married for a year and had given up the most beautiful part of my youth for a jerk who just bit me a few moments ago. Now I'm here, all alone, regretting and pitying my young dumb self who considered marriage a life decision as a new experience to fulfill my curiosity out of sensations. No one could ever imagine that my currently pathetic self used to have such a vigorous past with hot boiling passion and dreams. I used to have everything, college life, friends, and love. I met whom I called the guy. We did not mind, we just loved. He promised me a future full of sparks, wealth, and no worries. I was so tempted. One day, he suddenly proposed, and on the spur of the moment, I let out a soft yes, a word that led me to put college on pause to pursue my daydream. The first phase of this marriage was going well, I thought. He certainly knew how to make himself self-trusted.
What are you doing, hon?
I'm looking for internship programs. I put a pause on college for this marriage, so I need to do something to support our family financially as well.
What are you talking about? I'd rather you stay at home and be a homekeeper.
But I gotta have my own life too.
No worries, honey. I'm your family. I'm your life. I guarantee I will provide you with everything you need.
You promise?
Of course I do.
So, I ended up staying at home to be a good wife, as he said. I believed that he didn't want to burden me, and I was so grateful and touched about that. But as time passed by, the more effort I put in taking care of the house, the more annoyed he got whenever he came home after work. He started yelling at me for no reason, but I tolerated because I thought he was just under work pressure. Dear Yuho, are you tired? I've made dinner. Go have some.
Fuck off, you useless bitch.
Until that one day, things got worse and reached a peak.
Thank you.
What's wrong? You okay? You're drunk again. Why didn't you go home last night? Where have you been?
Shut up! That's none of your business.
What is this thing? The lipstick mark right here. And also the perfume doesn't smell right. And that means that you have the permission to lock me inside the house to hang out with a random slut out there?
How dare you call her that? You think you have the right to open your mouth now, huh? Get out of my way! You don't have the right to judge me! You're just a stupid eyesore who is jobless and stays in the corner of the kitchen doing nothing.
Her words moved me. They aroused my dying dream of a settled life. It's never too late to begin again. I escaped from that jerk's house and moved in with her. I started taking up new skills to get experiences, continuing college, applying for internships, opening up to people, managing my time, broadening my network, and so on. After acquiring the skills, I have realized that nothing matters when you are not aware of developing yourself.
Oh my god, what happened? Oh, don't cry. Don't cry. It's okay. Everything is gonna be fine. Just go out and tell me later, okay? Now just go out.
Okay, calm down. Just now tell me what is going on.
I've made a big mistake. I should not have put my faith in that jerk. This whole marriage is a mess. Can you imagine your husband beating you just because of a stranger whom he just met?
Well, that's just horrible. How long had it been going?
Since forever. He has always been domineering over me. He told me to do this and that, and I just had to tolerate because I felt like I'm under his obligation, and maybe he did that for my good.
That's not how marriages work. I warned you about this, but still you decided to ignore my advice and kept making impulsive decisions. In this case, I guess divorce is the only option for you and fight your true self back. It's never too late to go back, Tang.
But I have nothing now. No qualifications, no skills, no academic knowledge. How am I supposed to move on?